Wide is now classified as very high, and there are new cases of the disease here in the United States. 16.
And everybody ready? Roll camera.
Speeding.
And playback.
I put it in my pocket so that every day you're with me. I keep you close to my heart. Give me one more kiss before the boys arrive. Nashville to San Francisco is a hell of a drive. But don't worry, the Lord is good when the road is long. And we'll be back before you know.
I'm Mr. Theodosio, your Atwater High School principal, and I'm excited to welcome you to the new school year. I would like to especially welcome our newest Falcons, the Atwater High School class of 2024. We look forward to the adventures and successes you will have over the next 4 years. Let's have a great year, Falcons. Good evening. Welcome to the Facebook Live for Atwater High School for October 28th, 2020. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. There's a lot going on, and I'll be doing some introductions here in a second, but tonight we're going to be having our presentation translated as well. So I'm going to go ahead and ask Ms. Rosales, who will be translating, to go ahead and translate the welcome.
So, buenas tardes a todos. Hoy es October 28, 2020, y nos da mucho gusto que nos puedan acompañar hoy.
All right. My name is Brett Theodosio. I'm the principal here at Atwater High School, and I'm going to introduce the other folks that we have on the screen with us.
So, Mr. Theodosio nos va a introducir a todas las personas que están con nosotros esta noche.
We got Mr. Braga, our activities director.
El director de actividades.
We have Mr. Nunes, who's our associate principal for guidance.
El asistente principal.
Translating for us this evening is Ms. Socorro Rosales.
Buenas tardes, yo les voy a traducir esta noche.
We have Scott Wine, our athletic director, joining us.
El director de atletismo.
And our associate principal for student support, grades 9 and 11, and activities and athletics, Ms. Fonsevan.
Y la subdirectora de los grados 9 y 10 de atletismo.
Our associate principal for student support and attendance, grades 10 and 12. Mr. Davis.
Y el subdirector de asistencia.
And our associate principal for teaching and learning, Mr. Hammer.
Y el subdirector de aprendizaje.
Also joining us this evening, helping us with translation and our online responses is Ms. Zulma Ochoa.
Y también está la señora Ochoa ayudándonos a traducir esta noche.
Okay, to get us started this evening, I'm going to go over what to expect starting this next Monday. And with that, we're going to share my secondary screen here, and I'm going to share with you the Atwater High School webpage. I'll kind of walk you through it so that you can reference some information. So as we look here on the screen, when you go to Atwater High School or you look Atwater High School up online, this screen's going to pop up. It's kind of a landing screen that has Return to Learn, Updates, and Resources for everyone. And you can scroll through this page and click on different parts of the page to give you a lot of information. We have our Return to Learn in-person webpage. We have our AB schedule, which I'll be going over in a second. We have our Bell schedule that'll be on here. And then also a calendar of which days are A and which days are B. So let me just kind of go through this really quick. I'll let Ms. Rosales translate.
So de lo que vamos a estar hablando esta noche es del regreso a la escuela que viene siendo este lunes que viene. So si van a la página de la Water High School, pueden encontrar los recursos y pueden mirar qué es el calendario para regreso a la escuela del grupo A y grupo B. También pueden mirar el calendario de las campanas que va a haber para los estudiantes cuando regresen a la escuela. So hay muchos recursos disponibles en la página de Atwater High School.
So there's another place you can find this information as well. If you go to our regular Atwater High School webpage, up at the top, there is a red bar that you'll see here with a click here area that you can touch on.
También pueden ir a la barra en rojo que está en la página de Atwater High School para mirar más recursos disponibles.
Okay, this is going to take you to the District Return to Learn page. And on here, I'm going to take you first to the AB schedule and explain it.
So si van a la barra en rojo en la página de la escuela, los va a llevar a la página del distrito, donde les va a explicar cómo es que se va a llevar a cabo el regreso a la escuela en persona.
So if we click on this particular page, it goes into what the AB schedule will look like.
So, por ejemplo, si hacen clic en esta página, van a mirar cómo es que se va a mirar el calendario de regreso a escuela.
So, as you can see, for our students that have A, are part of the A group, they will go to school on Mondays. Every Monday, they will go to school in person here at Atwater High School.
So, si miran, pueden mirar en el calendario que los estudiantes que van a estar en el grupo A van a ir a la escuela todos los lunes.
And then the B students will go every Tuesday and Friday. So, A's are every Monday and Thursday, and B's are every Tuesday and Friday.
So, como miran aquí en el calendario, el grupo A va a asistir a la escuela los lunes y los jueves. El grupo B va a asistir a la escuela los martes y los viernes.
Then on Wednesdays, it will rotate between B and A every week.
Y los miércoles, lo que va a pasar es que se van a estar alternando entre el grupo B y el grupo A.
Okay. So, Mr. Hammer, first Mr. Nunes is going to go over here in a few minutes. When we get to Mr. Nunes, he's going to go over how you know if you are A or B, or online. So we'll explain that in just a minute. And then Mr. Hammer is going to go through and explain, what do you do with this? How do you log in? What does instruction look like if you're A or B or online? So we're going to get to that in just a minute. But before we go there, if you scroll down on this same page, you'll find the AHS Bell schedule. And if you click on the Atwater High School Bell schedule, and you click on right here on regular Bell schedule, it'll give you our regular traditional bell schedule. So school will start at its regular time at 8 a.m. Every single day for all students, first period will be at 8 a.m. And you'll just follow the regular traditional Atwater High School bell schedule. It'll be 47-minute periods with 6-minute passing periods. school will start at 8 a.m. So if you're curious, that's why I'm showing you the webpage so that you can go back and review and find this information later.
So estamos mirando ahora la página del calendario y de cómo va a sonar la campana. So para los estudiantes, para los padres que quieren saber de qué hora va a empezar la escuela, va a empezar a las 8 y va a terminar a las 2:37. Vamos a seguir el calendario normal de la escuela, de 8 a 2:37.
And I see already there is a question about zero period band. Mr. Flores will be contacting you regarding how zero period band is going to work. So he'll be reaching out to all of his students.
Para los estudiantes que están en banda, el maestro los va a contactar y les va a decir cómo es que van a asistir a la escuela.
Okay, if I scroll down further on this page, there's lots of information for people that are curious about how this is going to work for Merced Union High School District and for Atwater High School.
Si van hacia abajo en la página, pueden encontrar más información. Si gustan, miran más información y están curiosos de saber más información sobre el regreso a la escuela.
So as you can see here, you can click on the Merced Union High School District COVID-19 Exposure Prevention Plan for more information.
Por ejemplo, pueden hacer clic en Merced Union High School y pueden mirar las prevenciones que estamos tomando con el regreso a escuela con COVID-19.
There's also, if you click the next one, it's the COVID-19 exposure flowchart to explain what happens if somebody is exposed to COVID-19.
Si hacen clic en la segunda cajita, les va a mostrar qué es lo que pasa si alguien está expuesto al COVID-19 cuando están en la escuela.
And then down below, you'll have the standard operating procedures for cleaning and sanitizing at Atwater High School.
Y si hacen clic en la tercera cajita, van a mirar qué son los procedimientos que la escuela va a seguir para tener la escuela limpia.
Okay, so there is more information, but there, if you click on that, the red banner at the top, it's going to take you to the most current information for what's happening with the district in regard to school being in session and returning to learn.
Pero recuerden que si oprimen en la barrita roja arriba, los va a llevar a la información más reciente que hay disponible.
And then the last thing I'm going to mention as far as the webpage, if you look over here in this area where it says translate for our Spanish-speaking families, we can translate this to Spanish, the whole webpage, so it's more accessible right here.
So, por ejemplo, para las familias que necesitan traducir la página, recuerden que hay un botón donde pueden hacer clic, donde dice traducir y pueden traducir la página al español.
Okay. So that's all I'm going to cover for the webpage, but please make sure if you pull up the Merced Union High School District webpage or the Atwater High School webpage, go to the banner at the top.
So esto es todo lo que va a cubrir Mr. Teodosi hoy en la página de Atwater. Pero si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, vayan a esa página y pueden encontrar respuestas.
The next thing I'm going to cover is what our students need to do to make sure we have a safe school when we come back.
La siguiente cosa que vamos a hablar va a ser de qué es lo que los estudiantes deben hacer para estar protegidos en la escuela cuando regresemos.
Okay, so these are going to be what is expected of all of our students when they return. Everyone must wear a mask properly at all times while they're at school.
Todas las personas que estén en la escuela deben usar una máscara todo el tiempo que estén en la escuela. No se la pueden quitar.
Okay. Everyone must practice social distancing of at least 6 feet at all times.
Todos deben practicar la distancia de 6 pies.
Okay. When walking around the campus, we're asking our students for traffic flow purposes to stay to the right. Now, we will have signs to help out with this, but this will help students from avoiding walking into each other or walking in groups. So you'll see what we mean when we say stay to the right. It's like driving down the road. If you're traveling, just stay to the right of those folks that are going the other direction.
So, cuando los estudiantes regresan a la escuela, recuerden que todos los estudiantes deben de caminar en la dirección a su derecha. Habrá señales para indicarles hacia dónde tienen que caminar.
This is about the self-screen process before you come to school. If you have a fever, if you feel sick, or if you've been around anyone with COVID, that has been COVID positive in the last 14 days, we need for you to stay home and log in to your classes from home.
So, la próxima parte de la que vamos a hablar es muy importante porque si han estado expuestos a una persona que tenga COVID, si ustedes han tenido fiebre, tienen que quedarse en casa por 14 días, no pueden entrar a la escuela. Vamos a pedir que hagan las clases a distancia.
If you are staying home and not attending school, we'll need for you to call the attendance office to clear your attendance, but you can still log in from home if you're feeling well.
Para los estudiantes que se tengan que quedar en su casa a hacer una cuarentena, tienen que llamar a la escuela, a la oficina de asistencia y decirles que se van a quedar en casa, pero todavía se tienen que conectar a las clases en Zoom.
Okay. Something else to notice in our presentation this evening, we have important phone numbers that are scrolling at the bottom of the screen for our various offices on campus to support our families.
So, si miran abajo en la pantalla, pueden mirar teléfonos importantes de la escuela.
Okay, with that, we're going to move on now, and I'm going to go to Mr. Nunes in guidance to give you an update from the guidance side of the school.
Good evening. The first thing I wanted to talk about was how can you tell what group your student has? So, Mr. Braga, can you pull up the identifier?
So, ahora Mr. News va a hablar con nosotros de cómo es que pueden saber en qué grupo está su estudiante.
So, students should log on to ARES, and under the school, under the student info, there's a demographic tab.
So, los estudiantes tienen que entrar a su cuenta de ARES y pueden encontrar donde dice demografía y allí les va a mostrar.
On the after you pull up the demographic page, the school group is towards the bottom. It will say either A, B, or O.
El grupo lo van a encontrar abajo cuando entren a su página de ARES y entren a la demografía, ¿verdad? Lo van a encontrar hacia abajo, van a mirar el grupo A o el grupo B.
That's the first way to do it with your student. Mr. Braga, you can take that down. The other way is we sent every student a mailer home Tuesday. So you should be receiving something in the mail either tomorrow, hopefully, or Friday. And that will have your student schedule, which has pretty much stayed the same. We tried to keep every student's schedule the same. We did change a little bit in PE to align our distance learning PE and our in-person PE to separate those, but that did not change any periods. So every student will pretty much have the same exact schedule. In that schedule, you'll have the group number on the top.
So, todos los estudiantes van a recibir una carta a casa donde les van a decir si están en el grupo A o grupo B. Todos los calendarios de los estudiantes se quedaron igual. Solamente algunos estudiantes van a tener cambios en sus clases de física.
The other thing is if students were in a class that was over 15, we tried to limit every classroom to 15 or less. So that might have created a change in your student's schedule. So it might have been A at some point, and it got changed to a B or a B to an A if they had to move from a class to balance all the classes. But that did not change the schedule. It just changed the group.
So, algunos estudiantes sí hicieron un cambio del grupo B al grupo A y nada más estos cambios ocurrieron porque no podemos tener más de 15 estudiantes en la clase.
And that's about it for schedules. Also in that mailer is a calendar that Mr. Theodosio shared too, so you'll have one to put on your fridge or put somewhere you can see every day. And if you have any questions, all the phone numbers to the offices are in that mailer too. If you had a question concerning a certain office or a certain question, you can call any of those numbers.
So, en la carta que van a recibir a casa, van a recibir también el calendario del grupo A y el grupo B. Ese calendario lo pueden usar para saber cuándo es que tienen que asistir a escuela. También van a estar los números de teléfonos importantes que tienen que tener.
And that's it from guidance.
Y eso es todo de Mr. Nunes.
You're on mute.
There we go. Thank you, Mr. Nunes, for that. Next, we're going to go to Mr. Hammer for what students can expect to see when they attend class.
I'm going to try to share screen. I can do that.
Yes.
Is that working? Awesome. All right, we're going to keep it real simple. For return to learn, we're thinking broadcasting. And the way we'll go step by step, you'll hear the word broadcasting. It's because our teachers are on camera. And some of the kids are going to be at home. Some will be at school. But we'll all be in one class. Okay, that's our thinking. So you've seen the AB schedule. So students will know which group they're in. And whether they're going to be at home that day or they'll be at school.
It's okay, Mr. Hammer. Lo que vamos a estar usando es el radio fusión, que viene siendo una cámara. So los estudiantes que estén en casa van a mirar qué es lo que está pasando en la escuela y viceversa.
Good. All right. So you'll hear that the term will be broadcasting. There'll be students in the room and students at home. We've got that. For us, we have these fancy motion cams. So wherever the teacher goes, the camera's there. So if a teacher has to demonstrate or write on the board, the camera picks that up as the teacher moves.
So como les estábamos diciendo, vamos a hacerlo radio fusión. So los estudiantes que estén en casa van a mirar lo que está pasando en la escuela. Vamos a tener cámaras de emoción que siguen a los maestros.
Pretty cool. So let's say you're in group A. You're in class. You're receiving instruction. Of course, the students will be socially distanced, you know, the 6 foot, six feet apart. But they'll actually experience the teacher's lesson in the class.
So, por ejemplo, el grupo A, ¿verdad? Va a estar en la escuela, pero van a estar teniendo precauciones y estando 10 pies a distancia.
And they can ask questions and interact in the classroom as they normally would.
So, pueden estar en clase y pueden interactuar con los maestros en clase como normalmente lo hacemos.
Then our students, our group B will be at home.
El grupo B va a estar en casa, ¿verdad?
And they will see the same exact lesson that the students in the class are seeing, and they will be able to respond, and the teacher will have a speaker in the room, so they'll be able to be part of the lesson, but they'll be at home.
Los estudiantes que van a estar en el grupo B van a estar en casa, ¿verdad? Pero también van a poder participar porque van a mirar qué es lo que está pasando en clase, y el maestro va a tener un micrófono para poder responder a los estudiantes que están en casa.
So we think of two different places, but one class.
So pensamos en dos diferentes lugares, pero simplemente es una clase.
So the next day, they're just going to switch places.
El próximo día, lo único que va a pasar es que van a cambiar lugares.
So the idea is new lessons every day, whether it's from home or from the classroom, there'll be new lessons every day.
So la idea es de que todos los días haya una lección nueva. So no importa si estás en la escuela o estás en casa, va a ser una lección nueva.
One of the things I'd like to talk about are the addition of Go Guardian. This Go Guardian is a new program that we're going to be using that keeps students safe while they're online.
So lo que queremos hablar es de un programa que vamos a empezar a usar que se llama Guardian, que es un programa que ayuda a que los estudiantes también estén protegidos en sus casas.
And it also helps us assist the students with technical issues that they're having at home.
También nos ayuda a asistir a los estudiantes que tienen problemas con la tecnología en casa.
And this is connected to students' MUHSD Google account.
So, este programa está conectado a la cuenta de los estudiantes de Google.
Good. And we want to make sure that we remember the responsible use policy, meaning that our students will use the computer in the right way.
Queremos que los estudiantes sepan que tienen que ser responsables cuando están en la computadora y usen la computadora responsablemente.
So we just want to make sure that through this program, parents know and students that the students' internet activity can be monitored and the students should remember to make responsible choices.
So, con esta aplicación, lo que pasa es que la actividad de los estudiantes la podemos mirar.
Good. Then remember they should make responsible choices.
Recuerden que los estudiantes deben de tomar decisiones responsables cuando estén en línea.
Good. All right. The last piece is that I really want to make sure we know we're all in this together. So if you are an AB student or if you are distance learning, we are all in this together, okay? We want to get a make sure that we enjoy the lessons, we do some learning and progress the way we need to. So whether you are home, whether you're at school or all of the time on distance learning, we're here to serve you and support you, okay? So make sure, keep that in mind, and parents as well. My number is on the screen there somewhere. I do teaching and learning, and I'm also connected to AP exams. So feel free to contact me regarding any of those things.
So recuerden que todos estamos juntos en esto. No importa si están en el grupo A o en el grupo B o a distancia, todos juntos. Si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, contacten a Mr. Hammer. Su número de teléfono aparece abajo.
That's all I have, Mr. Theodosio.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Hammer. Next, we'd like to go to Ms. Fonsavon. Talk to us about facilities and food service.
Hi, everyone. Good evening. The first thing I want to go over is I want to go over cafeteria services. It's a little bit different, but I do want your students to know that we are offering food in more spots all over campus than normal. So we will have additional carts, so our line should stay down quite low. Nothing will be different in any of the stations. All the stations will have exactly the same thing. And our cafeteria is only going to be seating 49 students. And we took the tables out and we put desks in there. And the reason we did that was to make sure that the kids stay completely distant from one another. The biggest change, and the one that seems to be a little bit confusing to some people, is the A students, when they come on campus, they're going to get their breakfast and lunch, of course, on campus. But as they leave campus, they're actually going to be handed their lunch and breakfast for the following day. So it's very important that they exit out the front if they want to collect their breakfast and lunch for the next day.
Let's get Ms. Rosales.
Oh, sorry.
Let's catch up.
Okay. So lo primero que está hablando Mrs. Fonsavon es de las comidas que se van a ofrecer en la escuela. So empezamos con la cafetería. La cafetería nada más va a poder tener 49 estudiantes. Las mesas las quitamos de la cafetería por lo mismo que queremos que los estudiantes estén 6 pies de distancia. So los pusimos escritorios en las cafeterías. Y también queremos que sepan que va a haber diferentes estaciones en la escuela, va a haber más de lo normal para que puedan agarrar sus lunches. También queremos decirles a los estudiantes que, por favor, todas las comidas que van a estar sirviendo en las diferentes estaciones van a ser las mismas. Para los estudiantes que se van a ir a su casa después, pueden recoger una bolsa con el desayuno y el lunch del próximo día. Go ahead, Ms. Fonsavon.
You got that all?
I hope so.
Oh, you're awesome. And so the same thing with the B students, they'll get their food as they leave for the next day. Lastly is our distance learning students. They will only pick up their food on Wednesdays between 7 and 8, drive through in the student parking lot. And that will be giving them the entire week's worth of food.
So lo último que queremos recordarles es que es lo mismo para el grupo A y B. Los estudiantes que se van a quedar en casa, aprendizaje a distancia, nada más van a ser recibir su comida. I'm sorry, Ms. Fonsalbaum, what day was that? Was that Wednesday?
Wednesday.
Nada más los miércoles los estudiantes que están aprendizaje a distancia van a poder recoger su comida. Y vamos a hacerlo igual del carro, por favor. De 7 a 8.
I'm seeing a comment from Loretta, and you're absolutely right. The kids are going to be confused because I was completely confused at first. All of our liaisons know, all the admin know, we were going to be there practically 6 feet away, not holding their hands, helping them out and getting them through lunch and getting them their food. So we will be helping them. Lastly is I just kind of want to give a big, I guess, shout out to our custodians. Our custodians have been working their tails off, making sure everything is 6 feet apart in every single room. They have taken out, I would say, hundreds and hundreds of desks from rooms and found storage from them and just measured with tape measures every single classroom. So I can guarantee you that all your students are 6 feet from each other and 6 feet from any adult that are in every single classroom because our custodians did all of that. So, and then I'm so sorry.
Okay. So, Mrs. Fonsalbaum, nada más quiere decir a todos que queremos estar muy agradecidos con los custodios porque los custodios hicieron un gran trabajo sacando escritorios de las aulas ahorita que se necesita tener 6 pies de distancia. So, asegúrense que sus estudiantes van a estar alejados de cualquier otra persona 6 pies de distancia. So, no se preocupen, van a estar bien.
So if your students see a custodian on campus, if they can just, you know, thank them, say hello, they've been working night and day. And lastly, I just want to bring up Saturday school. We actually got some funds to run a Saturday school just until December. And this is for any student to come in and get any help. It's not for making up attendance. It's not for punishment. It's just to get extra support.
So lo que les quiere decir Ms. Fonsalbaum también es que nos dieron recursos adicionales y va a haber escuela los sábados. Solamente es para que los estudiantes hagan tareas. No es porque están en ningún tipo de problema. No es para también si faltaron algún día, no tienen que ir ahí para recuperar el día que faltaron. Solamente es para los estudiantes que necesitan ayuda adicional.
Okay, and that runs from 8 to 12 every Saturday, and they are provided food. And if they need transportation, it is available upon request.
So la escuela de los sábados va a ser de las 8 a las 12 todos los sábados. Y también les vamos a dar lonche y almuerzo a los estudiantes. Y también tenemos transportación disponible si la necesitan.
Any questions, you can email me and I can help direct you.
Si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, mándenle un correo electrónico a Mrs. Fonsalbaum.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Fonsalbaum. Next, we're going to go to Mr. Davis for attendance and any COVID protocols he'd like to cover.
Hi, good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight. I know that attendance taking is going to be a little more cumbersome for teachers, and I will be posting an infographic to Parent Square and also communicating. We do have a couple of new attendance codes that will be in place. So attendance has to be basically taken in 3 different categories. Basically, the in-person group, if the student is in class. Also, the students that are at home, but maybe in the alternating group, either the A or the B, depending on the day. And then also there's a section that is entirely 100% distance learning. So teachers do have to manage 3 different types of attendance taking for each period. So there is going to be a couple of new codes that I'll post out. But basically the one that you guys should be familiar with is the new code will be 5. That will be students are present for in-person learning in the classroom. So, you know, the A is still absent, the threes and the fours will still be there used for distance learning, and the fives will be for present in person. Sorry, Socorro.
Okay, no, it's okay, no worries. So, para tomar asistencia va a ser un poco diferente ahora que regresemos. Va a haber tres diferentes códigos, porque recuerden que vamos a tener los estudiantes en el grupo A, en el grupo B, y los que se van a quedar a distancia. So, el código más importante que estamos agregando es el código número 5, que es para los estudiantes que tienen que estar presentes en las clases. Y recuerden que la A quiere decir que no asistieron a clase. El 3 y el 4 todavía se va a usar para los estudiantes que estén haciendo aprendizaje a distancia. Go ahead.
So we also do encourage parents to call your student out if they're going to be missing for either distance learning or in person. Call our attendance office and make sure to clear their absence. And if you could do that within 48 hours, that would be much appreciated.
So, por favor, si saben que su estudiante no va a asistir a la escuela, por favor, llamen a la oficina de asistencia. Y sería muy agradecido si, por favor, llaman en las siguientes 48 horas.
So, as far as there was a question there about where students will be dropped off, we do have new perimeter fencing. And our campus liaisons will be opening up the gates to all of the access points on campus before school. And about 15, 20 minutes after school starts, our liaisons will be closing all of the perimeter gates, and they will only be able to enter campus through the main front entrance by the guidance office in the front of school there.
So, ¿dónde van a dejar a los estudiantes? Va a ser un poco diferente, pero van a ser 15 a 20 minutos antes de que empiece la escuela. Para los estudiantes que lleguen después de escuela, nada más va a haber una puerta abierta, que va a ser la que está en la entrada.
And same with the end of the school day, 15, 20 minutes before the end of the school day, the gates will be open for students to exit campus.
Y va a ser lo mismo a la salida de la escuela. 15 a 20 minutos antes de que suene la campana de salida, van a abrirse las puertas para que puedan salir los estudiantes.
So, touching on some COVID protocols, we are enforcing as best of our ability bathroom guidelines and the amount of students that are able to be in any particular restroom at one point in time during the day.
So, recuerden que para mantener una distancia apropiada, estamos siguiendo diferentes pautas que tenemos que seguir de cuántos estudiantes pueden entrar a los baños al mismo tiempo.
So, in addition to the bathroom use, if a student is not feeling well in class, or a teacher communicates with our health office, if a student is not feeling well, the student will be escorted up to our health office where they will be screened or communicated with by our nurse and our health clerk.
So, para los estudiantes que estén en la escuela y se estén sintiendo enfermos, por favor, déjenos saber para que los lleven con la enfermera y les puedan tomar temperatura y chequear qué es lo que está pasando, por favor.
If it's determined that the student has COVID-related symptoms, they will be placed in an isolation room in our health office.
Okay. So, si se determina que el estudiante tiene los síntomas de COVID-19, lo van a poner en otro cuarto donde no esté con otros estudiantes. Va a estar aislado.
So, as far as the other COVID protocols, it's obviously wearing your mask at all times. And ensuring that you are wearing your mask not only during class time, but also during passing period and at lunch. And it has to be worn properly.
So, recuerden que la cosa más importante es que todos los estudiantes estén usando su máscara. Tienen que usarla en clase y también cuando estén pasando de clase a clase. Muy importante de que la usen bien.
that's all I have from the COVID protocol standpoint there, Mr. Theodosio. If you wanted to touch on anything else or if there's any other questions that come up, I'd be more than happy to answer.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Davis. Again, there are more details on the webpage, like I pointed out earlier. If you want further details, you can either call or you can reference the webpage where our entire COVID plan is located that I explained a little bit earlier in the presentation. Again, this presentation is going to be posted on our webpage. So if you want to reference what we discussed this evening at a later time, or maybe you missed the presentation this evening or somebody missed it, they can pick it up at a later time after we get done with the live presentation. So next, I'd like to go to Mr. Wine, our athletic director, to discuss athletics with everyone.
Hello, everyone. I sent this information out today in Parent Square. So if there are more specific information, you can look at your email, hopefully, and see if there's anything I missed.
So el director de atletismo nada más quiere decirles que les mandó un correo electrónico. Si pueden mirar su correo electrónico, si piensan que les faltó algo o necesitan alguna pregunta, por favor, contáctenlo.
For sports, we are not doing anything as far as competition right now. We are working out. We are following the Merced County Department of Health guidance, being as safe as we can, but we are on campus working out for the last few weeks.
So para los deportes, recuerden, no va a haber deportes ahora, pero sí hay algunos estudiantes que todavía están practicando deportes en la escuela.
And thank you to our district leadership, our site administration, all the help, support, and supplies, really helping us stay safe and do the right thing.
Y él nada más quiere agradecer a todo el distrito, a todas las personas de administración por haberle dado todos los recursos que necesita para mantener a las personas con las que él está haciendo los deportes lo más protegidas posible.
So we receive new information almost every day. So keep in contact with your coach for specific information about your sport.
So parece que todos los días recibimos nueva información, so por favor comuníquense con la persona que tienen de maestro para su deporte.
So if you're on campus for the day, eventually but not now, do not expect locker room access. So if you're on campus, if it's an A day and you're an A student, do not expect locker room access someday down the road, but not yet. So I guess you have to wear some workout clothes, put some sweats over top. We're working on it, but as of now, do not expect to be able to get into the locker room yet.
So en este momento, los estudiantes no pueden usar los vestidores en la escuela. So por favor, pongan su ropa debajo de la ropa que usan para la escuela o hagan algo porque no lo pueden usar ahora los vestidores.
If you are off track that day at home, or if you're doing distance learning all the time, you can still participate. You just arrive for your workout, ready to participate at whatever time that workout is. Most of them are, you know, right after school. Some of them might be in the evening, but arrive at the correct time. Don't get here too early and try to hang around. You know, get there on time just for the workout and be dressed and ready to go.
So para los estudiantes que están en aprendizaje a distancia, todavía pueden participar. Nada más tienen que llegar a los horarios que se les indica.
We do expect to be inside, for example, the gym and the weight room here next week sometime. We're still working on plans, but we will have a safe weight room plan. It'll be limited, but we will be able to do some things. We will have a safe gym plan for those gym sports, volleyball, basketball, etc.
So esperamos que muy pronto podamos usar el gimnasio para practicar basketball, baseball, volleyball.
So when you arrive on campus to your workout, or if you're already on campus, wear a face covering. You'll probably wear a face covering for much of your workout, most of it. There will be some times where you can remove your face covering if you're really working hard, but for a lot of the times you'll have a face covering. Our district has, again, supplied us with some gaiters that you can pull up very quickly. So thank you again for those things. But again, face covering, almost all the time. So have one of those ready to go every day.
So cuando vengan a la escuela a hacer su rutina de ejercicios, por favor recuerden que tienen que usar la máscara. Siempre tienen que tener su máscara puesta apropiadamente.
And coaches will be screening and distancing and enforcing masks and you know, keeping all the athletes safe. So be sure to follow those coaches' guidelines while you're at your workout.
So todos los coaches van a seguir a las reglas de distanciamiento. So por favor, sigan las reglas de distanciamiento.
And remember, our goal is for all students, all 2,000 of us, to be involved in some way in something, sports, activities, FFA, band, drama. So again, we want you to be involved in as much as you can, but in a safe way. And I know we're working very, very hard to keep us all involved and to keep us all safe.
So lo que queremos es que todos los estudiantes, los 2,000 estudiantes que tenemos, estén involucrados en alguna actividad, pero siempre y cuando la estén practicando este adecuadamente y quedándose sus 6 pies de distancia.
Okay, very quickly, so how do you get involved? You've probably heard this from me many times. The quickest way is to contact the coach of the sport you're interested in. That's number one.
So la primera cosa que deben de hacer los estudiantes que se quieren involucrar en algún deporte es contactar al coach de ese deporte.
And complete an athletic participation form that includes a sports physical and turn that into the student body office.
Lo que deben de hacer segundo es completar una forma y llenarla y hacer un examen físico y entregarla en la oficina de atletismo en la escuela.
And create an athleticclearance.com account. If you have one from last year, update it. If you're an incoming ninth grader, create an athleticclearance.com account that has all your personal information. And those are the two things, sports physical, athletic clearance account.
So la tercera cosa que tienen que hacer es hacer una cuenta de atletismo. Pero recuerden también su físico, su examen físico lo tienen que hacer.
And we're all here to help. Myself, Mr. Calderon in the student body office, your head coach, contact us. We will, you know, do whatever we can. Call us, email us. We'll help you in any way we can. Get these forms to you, tell you where to find them. The website has everything on there, coaches' emails, athletic participation form. So check the website, call us, contact us.
So Mr. Scott quiere que sepan que todos estamos disponibles si tienen alguna pregunta. También Mr. Calderon está disponible si tienen alguna pregunta y pueden ir a la página de Atwater y encontrar los correos electrónicos de todos los maestros ahí, incluyendo los de atletismo.
So for now, again, I know it's not perfect, but at least we are able to work out. So be ready for no locker room. So be prepared, have some kind of workout clothes. Again, if you have to wear sweats over top, you know, do that. So be prepared for no locker rooms.
So recuerden, estén preparados porque no va a haber vestidores cuando regresen a la escuela. So no vestidores.
Your grades are very important for life, for graduation, but again, also for sports. Your grades will determine eligibility. So we want you to be able to have the fun of all the activities we're doing, but you know, if those grades are not very good, you're not going to be able to participate. So please, please, please keep those grades up. And I know it's not perfect at home, at school, A, B. I know sometimes it's confusing, but do the best you can. Keep those grades up as best you can so you can enjoy all of our activities.
So recuerden, sus grados son muy importantes. Son muy importantes también porque si no tienen buenos grados, no pueden participar en deportes. So recuerden tener sus grados muy buenos.
Again, contact us in the student body office. Contact the head coach of the sport you're interested in.
So recuerden, si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, contáctenlos. Déjenlos saber.
And soon, we'll be able to play and participate. So wear the mask, wash the hands, keep your distance, and let's go have some fun.
So recuerden que muy pronto podemos participar y hacer los deportes. So por favor, usen su máscara. Por favor, las máscaras.
All right. Thank you very much.
Gracias.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Wine. Last but not least, I'd like to go to Mr. Braga. Mr. Braga, can you tell us what students can expect when they come back?
Yes, Mr. Theodosio, good evening, everyone. We are going day by day in the old activities world. We are excited for everybody to come back next Monday and Tuesday. We have a little, I don't want to ruin the surprise, but we have something for the kids in the morning when they get onto campus. Go ahead, Ms. Rosales.
So estamos muy contentos de que los estudiantes van a regresar a la escuela la próxima semana. Tenemos una actividad especial cuando vengan los estudiantes la próxima semana, pero no queremos decirles, es una sorpresa.
And then school events for this week, we have a very exciting pumpkin carving contest. Mr. Nunes already cut his, I saw. And then a costume contest, all on Atwater High Instagram. That's going on this week. I'm serious. We're going day by day here. I know when we come back, though, we will have some clubs revving up more. It's just been good to have the kids back on campus this week. We've been doing freshman tours and orientations for a handful of our freshmen. It'll be good to have kids and that energy back on campus. That's it for me. We're short and sweet over here.
So vamos a tenemos dos eventos ahorita que están pasando, que es el evento de diseñar sus calabazas y el evento del traje de Halloween. Estamos muy emocionados porque esta semana pudimos tener algunos estudiantes en la escuela y algunos estudiantes del primer algo pudieron mirar las instalaciones de la escuela. So estamos muy contentos por eso.
That's it. We're rocking and rolling Monday.
Okay, very good. At this time, I would like to thank our amazing team of people that you see here on the screen. It's because of all the folks that you see here that all of this can happen. This has been a very challenging time for everybody in organization and logistics and communication. I want to thank everyone that you see here on the screen for taking the time this evening to be here to communicate and for making themselves available. Even after this presentation.
So, Mr. Teodoso, nada más le quiere agradecer a todas las personas que están aquí con él y le están ayudando en estos tiempos difíciles.
Okay. With that, I just want to also say that we are very excited for Monday. It's been 7.5 or 8 months since we've had students consistently on campus and going to class. We can't tell you how excited we are to have students back and to see students on campus.
So estamos muy contentos de saber que el lunes va a haber estudiantes en la escuela porque ya van 8 a 9 meses que no hay estudiantes consistentemente en la escuela.
Please remember and talk with your students, and students remember, we need your help to make sure this goes well. Please follow the COVID protocols so that we can stay in business, we can keep kids here, and we can all be safe and healthy as we do this.
So lo que les queremos pedir de por favor es que por favor recuerden todo lo que tenemos que seguir por las guías de del COVID. So recuerden si es space de distanciamiento.
We look forward to starting our journey back to normal, hopefully, and this is our first step. We're excited for Monday. We want everybody to have a great weekend. We wish you the best, and go Falcons.
So estamos muy contentos por el lunes y recuerden, go Falcons.
All right.
Set your clock back.
Yep, set your clock back this weekend.
Yeah.